A lawmaker wants you to stand in line at the DMV if you want to ride your bike on a public road or a public highway. Channel 9's Mark Barber discovered a new bill just filed today by a local representative would make you pay to register your bicycle just like a car.
One of the reasons why this new bill is getting so much criticism is drivers would have to register their bikes here at the DMV, where lines are already long.
It was a head scratcher.
Terry Lansdell is the head of the state's advocacy group for safe bicycling. He was stunned when he learned Alexander County Representative Jeffrey Elmore filed a new bike bill yesterday. House Bill 157 requires anyone over 16 to register their bike at the DMV. The annual registration fee costs $10. Riders have to add a license plate to their bike, and anyone who does not register can be fined $25. Mark Anthony runs a barbershop next to a Charlotte DMV office. It's hard to find the words to describe the lines he sees. If the new bill passes, Lansdell says the current 2 to 3 hour delays at the DMV would only get worse.
The DMV is struggling to keep up with automobile registrations. Now we're going to add potentially millions of bike registrations on top of them.
The fees from House Bill 157 would be used for bike safety projects, like the construction of more bike lanes. Lansdell says it sounds good in theory, but he says other states have already discovered there won't be any money left from the bike tax by the time the state pays for the costs of enforcing it.
The bike registration fees don't cover the cost of actually the registration process. It would overtax and overburden DMV at this point.
Now, if this bill does pass and you don't want to register your bike, you could face serious penalties. In cities like New Orleans, where there are already similar rules, bike infractions can actually count against your driver's license. Reporting here in South Charlotte, Mark Barber, Channel 9 Eyewitness News.
Some critics worry this will hurt low-income people in cities who cannot afford to buy a car. We tried emailing and calling Representative Elmore several times today to ask about all of this. We have not yet heard back from him.